Hi everyone. I went to the dentist this week and had some work done on my teeth. So I'm wearing a mask because it kind of looks a little bit funny. But I have a surprise for you today. I hope you've been following us as we've been talking about how Jesus said, "I will build my church." That means Jesus is building his church. Surprise is this. Pastor Terrence today is going to be sharing with you about his experience growing up in the church. So let's open with a word of prayer and then we'll hear from Pastor Terrence, okay? Let's pray. Dear God, we pray that you help us to learn from Pastor Terrence today, that our hearts will be open to know you and to love you. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen.
Good morning, boys and girls. This is Pastor Terrence. Auntie Katie asked me to tell you about what it was like for me growing up in the church as a child, like you guys. And so I'm so glad to be able then to share some of my memories and the things that were meaningful for me, but then also to be able to let you know how important it is for you to continue to be a part of our church family here at FCBC Walnuts, whether you come with your family, or you come with your grandpa and grandma, or you come with an auntie and uncle, or you come with somebody. We're just so glad that you are here in our church and that you're able to be a part of us. And so here's my story. My family is an immigrant family. That means that I wasn't born here. We immigrated and moved here to the United States from Taiwan when I was in third grade, like many of you. We didn't go to church when I was in Taiwan, but when we came here, we got connected to a church, not FCBC Walnuts, but another church. Through a family friend. And I didn't know anything about it. And maybe that's kind of like you guys too, although maybe there were some of you who never knew anything different than being at church. But it's okay. God is working through all of this. Anyway, so when I started going to the church, became memorable for me in a few different ways. First of all, it was just a lot of fun to come to church. We had a building that had different stories and stairways. There was a lot of different rooms. There was different floors. And so a lot of times, me and my friends, we just ran around campus. We played games together. Sometimes it was drawing on the whiteboard. Sometimes it was playing ping pong. Sometimes it was just finding places to hide. It was fun being with other people. And it was something that I was able to do regularly because we came to church every single week. During that time, then, I made some good friends. And we talked about all kinds of things. We went out and did things together. I was part of a children's choir. And so we had practices during the weekends too, 2 days a week, 2 hours each time. Imagine that. And so that was a lot of time and a lot of opportunities for me to be able to get to know a few people well. We went on trips, we did different things, and it was really special. In fact, a few of the friends that I had from back then. We are still friends today, and they're uncles too, and they're all married, and some of them have kids. And so now we get to play with each other's kids, and many of our kids are grown up more and more. And so we're making a whole new set of memories together. And all of that came together and started because I was at church when I was a child. Now, I also learned a lot about what it means to have faith. And that began with learning about the importance of knowing God. Through hearing from his word. So we spent time learning the Bible and remembering passages and receiving teaching and hearing sermons and explanations about what God said through his word. And even though at the time I didn't understand everything, it's okay because we're still always learning. And so many of the things that I remember learning back then are the things that I still believe in today and are the things that God is teaching me today to still hold on to and to live for. The famous passage, John 3:16, for God so loved the world that he gave his only son, that whoever will believe in him will not perish, but have everlasting life. I learned that as a child going to church. And now that is still so meaningful for me to remember that God loved us that he sent his son Jesus to die for the punishment that we deserved because he wanted us to be a part of his forever family through repentance and faith in Jesus. This is not something that we have to do alone, but that God sent the Holy Spirit to also change our hearts and to give us understanding and to be able to know what his Bible says, but then also to be able to live that out loud in our homes, in our schools, and with our friends. I learned all of those things when I was a child going to church, and that's still something that's really important for me now as a pastor, as a husband, and as a father. Finally, I came to see during my times there growing up that I was part of a family. Now, I came with my family, but I realized that I became part of a bigger family, a spiritual family. Jesus was talking to some people who were asking him and pointing out to him that his mother and his brothers were wanting to speak to him. And in Matthew chapter 12, verse 49, he responded with this statement. He said, "Here are my mothers and my brothers, for whoever does the will of my Father in heaven is my brother and sister and mother." And so he's looking at all the people that are there around him, and if they love God and they are children of his heavenly Father, then they became his brothers and sisters, mothers and fathers, grandpas and grandmas in Christ. We're part of this huge family because God is our heavenly Father in Christ. And that's special because a lot of times maybe our family is broken, or maybe sometimes we feel alone or we get into fights or there's things that we don't fully understand. It's very special for us to have a spiritual family of brothers and sisters, aunties and uncles. And that was many of my memories when I was growing up at church as a child, that there were all of these other people who were not my parents, who was not my sister, that still cared for me and where I belonged. So how can church be memorable and meaningful for you while you are young right now? Well, here's a few ways that you can make it special. Number one, keep building relationships. The other kids that are in your class, the people that you go to Awana with, the people that you're able to hang around on campus, especially when we reopen, we're able to see each other again. Get to know them. Get to know your aunties and uncles that are your teachers and that are your counselors and that are your leaders, because that's how you can build relationships with them. Ask them questions. Ask them about what the Bible means. Ask them about a verse that you don't understand. Ask them about why is there bad things that happen in the world if God is real. Ask us these questions. We want to talk to you. And then finally, keep coming to church. See, if we're part of a spiritual family and we want to be a part of this spiritual family, if we're not there, it's like there's some kind of family birthday party or family gathering, and we're just not able to be able to experience it. And so if the church is where God is the Heavenly Father and there's a spiritual family that is growing and there's a relationship with Jesus and the Holy Spirit is working in our hearts, then you should be here. We want you to be here. Keep coming and being a part of what FCBC Walnut is doing, whether online or in person. Did you know that Jesus loves children? That he looks at you guys and he wants you to be close to him. In Matthew chapter 19, verse 14, Jesus says this, "Let the little children come to me and do not hinder them, for to such belongs the kingdom of heaven." And he laid his hands on them and went away. Jesus wants you nearby. And so we want you nearby too. We want to get to know you. When the church reopens, we want to start things all over again when you guys all promote upgrade and be able to have the opportunity to learn about the Bible, to be able to grow closer to God, and to be able to build relationships with each other. I'm really excited to see you again as we go into the summer and as we start a brand new school year. So please build relationships with the people in this church, ask questions, and even ask for prayer, and keep coming because the church is a spiritual family where God is our Heavenly Father. So that is my story and how being at church when I was a kid was very impactful and has changed my life forever. And it's still changing me now. I hope to be able to learn more about your story when I see you around campus or if I ever get to catch you online. Have a wonderful weekend.